In this video, you will learn how to use the Classification Learner app to interpret complex machine learning models using partial dependence plots. We will begin by loading the credit rating dataset. To learn more about this dataset, you can find information in the credit rating demo example. You can load that like this. This opens a live script for the credit rating demo example. You can scroll down a little bit on this example. And with that, we see right here, this data set contains financial ratios, industry sector, and credit ratings for a list of corporate customers. This is simulated, not real data. The financial ratios included in the data set are defined here. We'll be referring to those financial ratios as we interpret the models later in this video. Coming back to our workflow in the command window, note that the industry and rating columns in this data set represent categorical information. So we want to convert their data type to categorical with these commands. Next, we want to reorder the credit ratings from highest, which is AAA, to lowest, which is CCC. And we can do that with this command. Okay, now we're ready to launch the classification learner. Next, we're going to start a new session using variables from the workspace. The classification learner automatically sees the credit data set and guesses that the rating is the response variable. In this case, that is correct. For all of our classification experiments, we'd like to exclude the customer ID because it doesn't have any relevance for predicting the corporate credit rating. It is just a numerical ID associated with the customer. So we will exclude it from being loaded as a feature. Okay, that all looks good. Let's use five-fold cross-validation and set aside 10% of the data for a test set. We can go ahead now and start the session. Now, in order to interpret some models, we need to first train them. There is a default tree model here. Let's add some other models. Looking at the models gallery, let's add a Gaussian naive Bayes classifier. And again, going to the models gallery, let's look at the ensemble classifiers and pick an ensemble of bagged trees. Okay, so now we're ready to train those models. Now we can rank these models according to their accuracy on the validation set. And we see that the ensemble of bagged trees is doing the best, so we can pick that as our favorite. We can confirm that the accuracy is similar on the test set, so the generalization capability of this classifier looks good. We can also see both the validation and test accuracy in one view by looking at the results table. Now we're ready to interpret these models. So let's select model 3, our model of choice, and we go to the plot and interpret section. Down here under interpretation results, we see the partial dependence plot. Now, by default, it shows the plot for the first feature variable listed here as WCTA, which stands for the financial ratio of working capital divided by total assets. The plotted lines here represent the relationship between this selected feature variable and the predicted scores for each of the possible output classes. If we highlight the line for the AAA class, we see that as this feature, the ratio of working capital to total assets increases, the score for the AAA credit rating generally increases. We will look at a different feature shortly, but first let's look at the meaning of the information shown along the x-axis here, with these tick marks. The x-axis minor tick marks represent the unique specific values of the selected feature, which appear in the selected data set. So in this case, there are minor tick marks along the x-axis for every unique particular value of the feature WCTA, which occurs in the test data set. There are 393 observations in the test set. That's 10% of the original data. So there are ticks for every unique value of WCTA in those observations. Due to the estimation process in the PDP calculation, the plotted lines are more reliable in regions where there is more data. So we're most interested in this area here, where there's more data for the estimation to make use of. Okay, so now let's change the view to look at a different feature. This is the MVE BVTD, which stands for the market value of equity divided by the book value of total debt. Simply put, this is the total value of the company's stock divided by the total value of the company's debt. For short, let's call it the equity to debt ratio. Now, given that most of the data and the plotted lines are on the far left, let's select the zoom tool, then select a region of interest on this plot with the x-axis between 0 and 10. Okay, so we would expect that when this equity to debt ratio is high, the credit rating is more likely to be good. And when this ratio is low, the credit rating is more likely to be bad. And that is exactly what we find in this BDP plot. And according to the plot, the score of AAA output class increases as this feature increases. Okay, so next, let's highlight the line for the AA class. The score for the AA class increases up to a feature value of about 2.9, then decreases thereafter. And we see similar behavior for the next several classes as we move to lower and lower credit ratings. So in conclusion, the PDP plot indicates the effect of the selected feature on the scores for each of the classes. In this way, PDP plots provide insight into what is causing a particular model to make a particular prediction. Thanks for listening.